So this mission is the first time NASA's going back to the moon in 51 years, which is quite exciting for the entire scientific community. And the telescope we're landing in is a radio telescope, and what you might ask what that is, and it's essentially like your cell phone detects radio waves. So we're actually going to be doing the same thing, but we want to detect radio waves from objects in space, such as the Earth, Jupiter, and the galaxy we live in. Most of my research throughout my entire career is trying to understand the magnetic fields of exoplanets. And the best way you can understand the magnetic fields of exoplanets is observing their radio emission. The radio waves that we're detecting with ROLSES, you can't hear with your ears. So all the data we're getting is just basically converted from the telescope into something that we can visually see and work with and try to figure out what the signals are telling us. Anything we learn from this will be applied to future missions. Eventually, we want to build Farside, which is going to be a very gigantic telescope. So there's going to be thousands of individual radio telescopes that are spread across many kilometer area on the far side of the moon, and that we eventually combine all those the light from each little telescope together to get really good sensitivity. And that is a telescope that we can actually use to study exoplanets in the radio, including some of the nearby habitable planets. So ROLSES is going to be basically a starting point for larger and bigger missions that are going to be sent to the moon, including humans eventually. So it's going to be testing a lot of the technologies and techniques that we eventually want to send more missions to the moon, both for science as well as human exploration. You know, all the scientists and engineers have been working years on this mission. People I've never even met, thousands and thousands of people. So it's kind of a dream come true, honestly.